The following is a class on the second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita as it is, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 17, 1975, in Durban, South Africa.
I shall speak some verses from Bhagavad Gita, second chapter, in which the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, instructed. The beginning of instruction is the second chapter, Bhagavad Gita. So Arjuna, representing ourselves, conditioned soul, covered with the material body and thinking in bodily conception of life, he was to fight with his brothers, nephews, grandfather, Bhishma Dev, also teacher in military science, Dronacharya. In this way, the business was not very palatable, although he was forced to fight. But the opposite party were very near, thick and thin people, and he had to kill them, so it was not very satisfactory to him. Therefore, he flatly denied to fight. Krishna, I am not going to fight. He left his weapon and then Krishna was surprised that my friend Arjuna, he is denying to fight in my presence. So Sanjaya, the private secretary of Maharaj Dhritarashtra, he was relaying the message which was going on in the battle of Kurukshetra. By fire process, nowadays we have got experience of the television, but the another process, antardrishti, that is also television. You can see the reflection of external activities within your heart, and you can explain. So Sanjaya, the private secretary of Maharaj Dhritarashtra, he explained that Arjuna was denying to fight. So Sangatatha Kripayavishtam Asupurna Kulekshanam Vishidantam Idangavacham Uvacha Madhusudha. Madhusudha is Krishna's another name. So when Krishna saw that Arjuna is unnecessarily disturbed, then Tangatatha Kripayavishtam Asupurna Kulesh Kharam Asupurna. His eyes were full with tears. Krishna, I have to fight with my relatives. So he was crying that this is not very good business. So why he was crying? Kripayavishtam, being merciful upon them. They were so cruel upon the Pandavas that they insulted their wife, they tricked how to take away their kingdom. All these injustice was done to them. Still, because Arjuna is a Vaishnava, a devotee, still he was sympathetic. Now, let them do whatever they have done, but I am not going to kill them. So, kripaya avishtam asukurla kuletsanam visidam. Bhagavan was. Then, after Arjuna being silent not to fight, then Bhagavan, Krishna is Bhagavan. Bhagavan means the Supreme Personality of Godhead, full with all opulences. That is called Bhagavan. Generally, in India, we speak Bhagavan. Bhagavan means one who has got opulences. So, Bhagavan means one who is full in opulences, in wealth, in strength, in influence, in beauty, in education, in renunciation. In these six ways, when one is opulent fully, then he can be called Bhagavan. Partially, if one is very opulent, sometimes he is also called Bhagavan. But real Bhagavan, according to Shastra, is Krishna. Krishna su Bhagavan Swayam. Others, they may possess some of the opulences, not in full, partially. Just like Narada Muni or Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, they are also sometimes called Bhagavan. But real Bhagavan is Krishna. Krishna su Bhagavan Swayam. Iti Changsakala Pungsa Krishna su Bhagavan Swayam. So here Bhagavan, the Supreme Person, Krishna. Krishna means, as Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, matta paratanam nanya kinchidasti dhananjaya. There is no more superior person or element more than me. And when Arjuna understood Krishna, he also admitted param brahma param dhama pavitram paramam bhavam. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the origin of Brahma. He is the origin of Paramatma. Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavan iti sabdase. The absolute truth is experienced in three ways. Brahma, Paramatma and Bhagavan. So Bhagavan is the last word of the absolute truth, the Supreme Person. Therefore, Vyasadeva has purposefully written here, see Bhagavan Vacha. Bhagavan Vacha means you cannot exceed the Supreme Person. Nobody can be equal to the Supreme Person. Nobody can be more than the Supreme Person. Everyone should be under the Supreme Person. That is the meaning of Bhagavan. So Bhagavan said, kutastha kasmalam idam visame samupasthitam anajyajishtam asagdam akitti karam arjun. My dear Arjun, you are my friend, personal friend, and you are proposing this which is befitting to the anarya, anarya system. This is not for the Aryan. You are kshatriya. You are meant for fighting for justice, and you are denying to fight. Oh, this is not good. Anarya system. This kind of proposal, cowardice, can be proposed by the anarja. Arya means the advanced. One who is advanced in knowledge, in civilization, they are called Arya, Aryan civilization. So in the Aryan civilization, there are four divisions. To maintain the society in the correct balance, that is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Chatut varnang maya system guno karma vibhava. The society must be divided into four classes of men. The first class means most intelligent class of men. They should be trained up as Brahman. Sama, Dama, Sattam, Saucham, Pritiksha, Arjamam, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astikam, Brahmakarma, Sabhava. So, this is the beginning of civilization. Not that all Shudras, as it is now, in this age, Kalau Shudra Sambhava, Kali Yoga, there is no training. How to train, qualify a section of person to become first class Brahmana? That training is not there. Neither Kshatriya, neither pure Vaishya class. We are proud of our business, Vaishya. But Vaishya means Krishi Goraksha Vanijyam Vaishya Karma Sabhava. Vaishya means they should take care of the cows, cow protection, Goraksha. Why Goraksha? Why not other animal Raksha? Krishna has not said animal Raksha or Janwar Raksha, Goraksha. A cow is very, very important animal. If you want to advance your spiritual consciousness, then you must have sufficient milk and sufficient grains. That is civilization. Therefore, it is the duty of the Vaishya to produce food grain. Annar bhavanti bhutan. Annar, if you have any society, if you have got sufficient anna, both the animals and the man, they will be happy. These are the instructions in Bhagavad Gita. Everything practical. If we follow Bhagavad Gita from all angles of vision, social, political, economical, religious, cultural, you will be perfect. This is Bhagavad Gita. We are therefore taken up this mission to preach Bhagavad Gita as it is, to solve all the problems of the world. That is Aryan civilization. Aryan civilization means following the principles of Bhagavad Gita. So here Krishna is addressing Arjuna on Arj, not Aryan. You are Kshatriya. Your service is now required to fight with persons who have created injustice. So what is this that you are denying to fight? Anarjajustam and asaddam. Asaddam means by denying your duty, you cannot be elevated in your next life, or you cannot be elevated in the higher planetary system. For a Kshatriya, it is the duty of the Kshatriya to fight and lay down his life. Then he is promoted to the higher planetary system. That is the Shastric Indian. If he becomes victorious, then he enjoys this material world. And if he dies, he is promoted to heaven. These things are there. Therefore, Krishna is advising Arjuna, asaddam. If you deny to fight, then you will be refused to enter into the higher planetary system of Kirti Karam. And you are no as a great fighter, great soldier, and my friend, and this will be going against your reputation. Don't do this. Then he says, Klaibangama asma gama pratha naitattai upapadyate khudrang vidayadodbarnang taktatrishta parantapa. My dear friend, parantapa, parantapa means one who gives trouble to the enemies. This is the material world. A kshatriya cannot behave like a brahmana. To excuse. Brahmana business is to excuse. Kamaruko tapasina. Those who are tapasi, they can excuse. But those who are in the governmental power to make justice, there is no question of excuse. Life for life. You have killed one man, you must be killed. This is justice. A brahmana, he makes use, all right, you have killed my man, never mind, I excuse you. That is Brahmana's business. But the Kshatriya, the government, the ruling power, he cannot do so. It is his mercy. It is the government's mercy. When a murderer is hanged, that is the injunction in the Manusanga. So Parantapa, you are Kshatriya, your business is to punish the unjust. So, khuddang ridayodurpanam. For a kshatriya, this kind of poor heartedness, that I shall not fight. Give it up. Don't indulge in such things. Then Arjuna said, Arjuna replied, Kathang bhishmamaham sankhe dronam cha madhusudana isu hi bhajidasrami Pujaraha Rishudana. He is addressing Krishna as Arishudana, the killer of the enemy. He says, but in my case, I have to fight with Bhishma, Dronacharya. They are my well-wisher. And how can I kill them? It is my duty to offer my respect, touching their feet, and you are enticing me to pierce their body with arrow. So, of course, you have killed so many enemies, but you have killed enemies. Why you are inducing me to kill my grandfather and my teacher? This is, of course, Arjuna also intelligent. He replied that you cannot accuse me as anarya. This is the consideration. Therefore, I am hesitating to fight. Then he said, Guru Nahatta hi Mahanubhava Shreya Bhoktum Bhoikam Apihaloke Itya Satyata Kamansu Guru Nihaiva Bhunjiya Bhogana Rudhira Pradigha. They are not only my grandfather, their Guru, and Mahanubhava, very great personality, Bhishma Devi Dronacharya. So if I kill them, and if I live prosperously, taking the kingdom, do you think it is all right that I live on the blood of my Guru and great personality? Do you think it is all right? Of course, he says, Nachaita vidvam kataranna gariya jadva jayema jadivana jayeyu janeva hatyana jijivishama te avastita apro mukhe dhaturasra. Krishna, actually I am puzzled. It is my duty to fight. But now I am puzzled whether I shall fight or not fight. Because after all the other side, they are my relatives, family members, dhaturasra. Dhritarasra is my elder brother of my father, and his sons, they are my cousin brothers. So I am puzzled whether I shall fight. He plainly explained his position, that not that I have become anarya, I have got sufficient strength, I can fight. But I am puzzled whether I shall fight in this case or not. Then he submits, Tatpanna dosho upahata sabhava, prichyami tanas dharma sangamura chita. Jat chayasya nishitam bhritan me, shishakti han sadhiman tana prapanyam. Then Karjuna decided to accept Krishna as his guru. Shishastiham, I become your disciple. To become disciple means no more argument. When we talk friendly, there is argument, counter argument. But when there is order from guru, there is no more argument. Therefore, Arjuna says, the katpanna dosho apahata sabhava. Actually, my behavior should be exactly like a kshatriya to fight for the just cause. But in this case I am denying, therefore I am kripon. Kripon means one who does not properly use his position. One man is very rich, but he does not use his money, simply sees the money. He is called kripon. Similarly, Arjuna is powerful, he can fight, he is a kshatriya, but he is denying his ability. Therefore, he is thinking that I have become kripon, miser. Although I have got strength, I am denying to fight. Although I have got money, I do not spend. These are called kripon. The katpanna dosha abha. Now I am infected with katpanna dosha. Katpanna dosha apahata sabhava. So when we become puzzled with these material affairs, what to do, not to do, this is the example. At that time, we must approach a guru. That is the instruction here we see. Jachya, prichyami tan dharma sangamura sita. When we are bewildered, we do not distinguish what is religious and what is not religious. Do not use our position properly. That is tatpanna dosha apahata sabha. At that time, there is need of guru. That is the Vedic instruction. Tadvijnanartham sa guru meva vigacche. Sutriyam brahmanistham. This is the duty, this is civilization. That we are meeting with so many problems of life. That is natural. In this material world, the material world is problems of life. Padang padanga jada vipadam. Material world means in every state there is danger. That is material world. So, therefore we should take guide from guru. From the teacher, from the spiritual master, how to make progress. Because this, that will be explained later on. That the goal of our life, at least in this human form of life, in the Aryan civilization, the goal of life is to understand our constitutional position, what I am. What I am. If we do not understand what I am, then I am equal to the cats and dogs. The dogs, cats, they do not know. They think that they are the body. That will be explained. So, in such condition of life, when you are puzzled, actually you are puzzled every moment. Therefore it is necessary one should approach to a proper guru. Now, Arjuna is approaching Krishna, the first class guru. First class guru. Guru means the Supreme Lord. He is guru of everyone, Paramguru. So, anyone who represents Krishna, he is also guru. That will be explained in the fourth chapter. Evaṁ parampara prāptam imaṁ rājarsa yogidu. So, Krishna is showing example. Where we should offer our surrender and accept Guru. Here is Krishna. So you have to accept Krishna or his representative as Guru. Then your problem will be solved. Otherwise, it is not possible. Because he can say what is good for you, what is bad for you. He is asking, Jat Shreya, Nishtitam Bruhitam, Nishtitam. If you want advice in instruction, Nishtitam, which is without any doubt, without any illusion, without any mistake, without any cheating, that is called Nishtitam. That you can get from Krishna or his representative. You cannot get right information from the imperfect person or a cheater. That is not right instruction. Nowadays it has become a fashion. Everyone is becoming guru and is giving his own opinion. I think in my opinion. That is not guru. Guru means he should give evidences from Shastra. Jashastra vidimusrijya vartate kamakara. Anyone who does not give evidences, proof from the Shastra, then no siddhin sabhavnati. He does not get at any time success. No sukham, neither any happiness in this material world. No parangati. And what to speak of elevation in the next life. These are the injunctions. So we must select Guru. Here it is example, Arjuna. He is accepting Krishna as Guru. Why he is accepting? Because he said, Nahi prapasyami mamapunadya jachoka mucchu sanamindriyana avapva bhumava asapatna vidyam rajyam sukhanam abhijadipatyam. So, he has selected that the right person, Guru, and he says that unless I hear from you what is right and wrong, I cannot decide whether I shall fight or I shall not fight, which way is better for me. I cannot understand. In this way, eva mukta rishikesham gurakesha parantapa najasta iti govindam uktya kusning babuva. And after everything, Krishna, that you give me the right direction, otherwise I am not going to fight. He left his weapon and became silent. Tamuvata rishikesha prasanni babhara. Senaya Rubhayan Madhi, Visidantam Idamabhas. Now, Krishna took the position of Guru and he began to instruct. Tamuvacha Rishikesha. Rishikesha, Krishna's another name is Rishikesha. Rishikesha means Rishika Isha. Rishik means the senses and Isha the master. Therefore, Krishna is the master of our senses. Everyone senses. That will be explained in the 13th chapter. The khetragancha pimana vidhi sarva khetre subhava. In this body, there are two living entities. One is myself, the individual soul, atma. And the other is Krishna, paramatma. Ishara sarva bhutana vidhi sarvajana tishtati. Actually, the proprietor is Paramatma. I am given the chance to use it. So my senses, so-called my senses, that is not my senses. I have not created my hand. The hand is created by God, by Krishna, through the agency of this material nature. And I have given the hand to use it for my purpose. For my eating, for my collecting. But actually it is not my hand. Otherwise, when this hand becomes paralyzed, I am claiming my hand, I cannot use it. Because the power of the hand is withdrawn by the proprietor. Just like in a house, rented house, you are living. If the proprietor of the house, landlord, ejects you, you cannot be there. You cannot use it. Similarly, we can use this body as long as the real proprietor of the body, Rishi Kesha, allows me to stay here. Therefore, Krishna's name is Rishi Kesha. And this Krishna consciousness movement means that we have accepted the senses from Krishna. It should be used for Krishna. Instead of using it for Krishna, we are using it for our sense gratitude. This is our miserable condition of life. It's like you are living in a place for which you have to pay rent, but if you don't pay rent, you think that it is your property, then there is trouble. Similarly, Rishi Kesha means the real proprietor is Krishna. I have been given this property. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Ishara sarvabhutana riddeshe arjuna tishtati bhramayan sarvabhutani jantra rurani maya. Jantra, it is a machine. This machine has been given by Krishna to me. Because I desire that if I get a machine like a human body, then I can enjoy like this. So Krishna fulfills your desire. All right. And if I think, if I get a machine in which I can directly suck blood of other animals, all right, Krishna says, he takes the machine of a tiger's body and uses it. So this is going on. Therefore his name is Rishi Kesha. And when we understand properly that I am not the proprietor of this body, Krishna is the proprietor of the body. I wanted a certain type of body to use it for my sense gratification. He has given it and I am not happy. Therefore, I shall learn how to use this machine for the purpose. This is called Rishi. Rishi Kena, Rishi Kesa, Sevanam Bhakti Vityate. When these senses, because Krishna is the proprietor of the senses, he is the proprietor of this body. So when this body will be utilized for Krishna's service, that is our perfection of life. Rishi Kena, Rishi Kesa, Sevanam Bhakti Vityate. Sarvapadhi Vinirmuktam, Tatparatena Nirmalam. Rishi Kena, Rishi Kesa, Sevanam Bhakti Vityate. If you want the definition of bhakti, the bhakti means to use the things for the purpose. That is right use. If somebody used for another purpose, that is misuse. So bhakti means when things are used properly, that is called bhakti. Now we are thinking that this machine, this body, I am born in India. So it is Indian machine. It should be utilized for India's profit. Another person is thinking, this machine, it is gotten from America, so it should be used for America. That is going on in the name of nationality or communism or society or friendship and this and so on. We have invented so many isms, but they are all misused. Because actually the machine does not belong to the American or the Indian or the African. The machine belongs to Krishna. So this is misuse. So when we understand that we are misusing this machine improperly, that is called pure machine. That is called pure understanding or Krishna consciousness. Sarvabhadhi-vinirmuktam. I am not American. I am not Indian. I am not Brahman. I am not Kshatriya. I am not human being. I am Brahma. I am Brahma. Not the Supreme Brahma. But part and parcel of Brahma. Supreme Brahma is Krishna. Parabrahma. He is addressed as Parabrahma. So, we are part and parcel of Brahma. Therefore, we are Brahma. So we have to realize this position. Aham Brahmas, I am Brahma. I am not this machine. I am put into this machine. But because the machine is gotten either from America or from India or from heaven or from hell, I am designating this machine as American machine or Indian machine. Actually, this machine belongs to Krishna and it should be used for Krishna. Therefore, the definition of bhakti means Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Rishad. This is bhakti. So, Krishna, now he has taken the position of teacher. Now no more friendly talking, because Arjuna has accepted him as the teacher. So he is the teacher, it is the duty of the teacher to punish or to chastise the disciple when he is wrongly going on. That is the duty. So, first teaching of Krishna, because Arjuna has accepted his leadership, his teachership, his instruction, accepted that he will follow his instruction. The first instruction is asochyananusochastam pragyavadam sabhasi. You rascal. You are rascal, you are talking like a very learned man. That, how shall I kill my grandfather, how shall I kill my brother, how this and so on. This is all bodily concept of God. You are talking on the bodily platform. So, what is this body? This to be neglected? Yes! Asachyananusochastam. It is not to be lamented. Asachyananusochastam pragyavadansa gatasum abatasum sa nanusochanti pandita. Pandita means one who knows that I am not this body. That is pandita. The body is a lump of matter. So what is the value of lump of matter? Either while it is moving or while it is not moving. It is a lump of matter. Suppose we are not moving with this body, with nice coat, pants, hat. That's all right. But what it is? It is a lump of matter. Either coat, pants or these bones and the skin and the blood and the stool and urine. Whatever this body is composed of, it is all material. And when the living entity goes away from this body, the same love comes back. Does it change? So we are not lamenting at the present moment because it is moving. And as soon as the movement is stopped, I say, oh, my father has gone, my son has gone, and we lament. So, actually the body is the same. The same body is lying here as dead body, whom you are lamenting, my father. But you have never seen your father. You have seen only the coat and pants and the body. That is your education. Therefore, Krishna says, Arjuna, you are thinking on terms of this coat and pants and bones and muscles and urine and stool. Therefore, you are rascal number one. This is the first step. Aso chananusuchastam. Pragya, do any gentleman lament for these torn up cloth, bones and skins and urine and stool? Does any sane man lament? This is the first thing. So, aso chananusuchastam. Pragya vadam subhas. You are talking just like a very learned man. To argue with me. But you are fool number one. Because agatasun, gatasun, agatasun cha, nanusochanti pandita. This is not the business of the pandit. So this is not the position of Arjuna only. The whole material civilization, the whole population of the whole world, they are like this. Asachyananusochastam. When the body is living, when the body is moving, they are busy how to make the body comfort. And when the body is not moving, they are lamenting. That is the business. Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma Na Sochati Na Kanti. Our business is The material civilization means sochati kankhati. Two business. Kankhati means desire. While the body is moving, we are desiring, making plans. I want this, I want this, my son requires this, my nation requires this, my community requires this. This is means kankhati, desiring to possess this body. And when the body is lost, then sochati, oh, my father is lost, my brother is lost, my son is lost. True business. So long there is no spiritual knowledge, we have got on the material conception of body, true business. Sochati, kankhati. Desiring for things which you do not possess, and lamenting for things which you have lost. This is our true business. But if you become self-realized, if you become aware actually what you are, then na sochati na kankhati brahma bhuta prasannatma na sochati na kankhati samas sarvesu bhutesu madbhakti labati param. This is the business. So our this Krishna consciousness movement is trying to educate people to give up this bodily concept of life. This is the sum and substance of this movement. And unless you come to understanding that I am not this body, I am a spirit soul, my aim of life is missing, then you remain cats and dogs. Jashyatma buddhi kunapi iti dhatuke sadhik kalatra visubhavumajyadi jatitha buddhi salilena karhiti janesu avidnesu saiva gokhap. Anyone who is leading his life on the bodily concept of life, he is no better than the dogs and hogs. So, in order to stop the civilization of dogs and hogs, the Krishna consciousness movement is essential. Krishna consciousness means to take instruction from the Krishna. This is the first instruction. Asachyanamishutasthang prajnavadhamsabhaj. So gradually he will give instruction. So this is our request, that you try to study Bhagavad Gita as it is. Don't try to distort it by your so-called education. Try to understand Krishna as he is saying. Then you will be benefited. Your life will be successful. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. That is spirit soul. Sat means eternal. And chit means knowledge. And ananda means bliss. So, if we study ourselves, this body is not eternal. Sat means eternal. So if we study this body, in the Bhagavad Gita, you find antavattu me deha nityasu kasarina. This body is antavattu. It will perish. Therefore, it is not soft. Soft means eternal. And the body is not eternal. Therefore, it is very difficult to understand what is soft. Because we have no education, no experience. Everything is annihilated, destroyed, anything material. So actually we have no experience, but it's soft. So, but Vedic instruction is sadgama asatuma. Don't remain in a soft, non-eternal. Come to the platform of eternity. Sadgama asatuma. So, that is the mission of life, human form of life, is distinct from the cats and dogs. Because if you instruct to the cats and dogs what is soft and what is unsoft, it is impossible for them to understand. It is not, therefore, basic instruction is, asatoma, don't remain cats and dogs. In the human form only. You come to the platform of eternity. Asatoma, sadgama. So we must try what is eternal. So far at the present condition, as this material condition, we do not know what is actually eternal. Because our body is not eternal. Therefore the first instruction is that you are lamenting on the body which is not eternal, but you are eternal. Your business is to understand the eternal. That is called self. And chit. Chit means knowledge. Knowledge, at the present moment, we are all in ignorance. We do not know what is the next step, whether I am going to live or to die. Everything in ignorance. Therefore this body is also not chit. It is full of ignorance. That sat, chit and ananda, that we have got experience. Where is ananda? Ananda means blissfulness, joyfulness. There cannot be any joyfulness in this body. There are three kinds of miserable condition of material life. Adhyatmik, adhibhautik, adhidvaitik. So either these three or one or two is always there. Adhyatmik means miserable condition on account of the body and mind. So wherever we go, the body is there. So even if I am very opulent materially with wealth, we are getting experience that even the most richest man in the society, he is committing suicide. Why? He has got every resources to enjoy. Why is committing suicide? That means there is also no ananda, even if you possess the material things. So there is no question of sat-chit ananda in this material condition of life. If you understand what is spiritual life, and if you practice how to come to the spiritual life, spiritual platform, as Krishna is, then we can become equal with Krishna, Satchidananda. Otherwise, we are in ignorance. This body is not Satchidananda.